the kid humps dessert, right? Is that what this song is about? There's always weird references in it, but...
I mean, it led to that.
It did, didn't it?
Yeah.
This song was
inadvertently, this song led to a major motion picture being made about sticking your wiener in an apple pie.
Yeah, kid humping a pie. Yeah. It's song's older than I am, I think. Don McLean, of course, American Pie was the biggest hit this guy ever had. 1971, so this song has been around for 50-plus years. Day the Music Died, of course, refers to... Well, we were talking about this not long ago. Richie Valens dying in that plane crash along with Buddy Holly and...
The Big Bopper.
Yeah, the Big Bopper. I think Poundcake thought that his name was La Bamba. Who died in that plane crash? La Bamba died in that plane crash. But, you know, he refers to Jackie Kennedy, and he's, you know, talking about Vietnam War and all that kind of stuff. Well, people are talking about the song today because it has held a record for 50 years, but it no longer holds that record. It was the longest song to hit number one on the Billboard charts, and he's been dethroned by the new version of that long-ass Taylor Swift song.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the song that she did on SNL.
So that's a spot for long songs, huh?
Called All Too Well is the song. And it's a not very thinly veiled song about her breakup with Jake Gyllenhaal over a decade ago. It's about an hour per year that the relationship... a minute per year that the relationship has been over between her and Jake Gyllenhaal. But whatever. She's re-recording all of her old songs, blah, blah, blah. So... American Pie is no longer holds that record. The Taylor Swift version of All Too Well is over 10 minutes long, and it is getting played on pop radio.
You could
play four other songs in that amount of time on pop music stations.
Yeah, but they know if they put that on at the right time, just over the quarter hour.
Yes, that's absolutely correct.
You're getting listeners.
You're very rarely going to get that kind of home run in pop music. So Don McLean got flowers from Taylor Swift. He's 76, and of course, she's a classy gal. She wrote him a note, and people are talking about American Pie again. And so he took the opportunity to announce his tour. The 50th anniversary of American Pie. He's going back out on the road. Again, God bless Don McLean. I was always curious what he did after playing American Pie.
Well, he doesn't do anything before. I mean, he ain't opening with this. He's closing with it.
Right, but could you... And again, I'm not well-versed in his catalog, but I couldn't name you another Don McLean song.
Neither could I. But I'm sure there's people that could.
He had fans.
Not exactly... I mean, like you said, this song's older than you.
Yeah. So when he goes out on tour, where does he perform? Like, is he an arena guy? Is he a theater guy?
No, he's doing auditoriums. Yeah. I mean, he's
he'd probably do like...
He'll go out
is
the...
Is he a Blossom guy?
No. Blossom. Not by himself, I don't think. I think he's on a... He does like the Rock Legends cruise. So it's like him and Styx and Blue Oyster Cult and... You know, Artemis Pyle, you put a bunch of them together and they can go out on a cruise. His tour, though, is going to be... you'd have to go to Toronto to see him if you're a fan in Cleveland. Because he's not coming to Cleveland.
That's the closest spot is Toronto?
Yeah. Grand Rapids, Michigan, Toronto.
I'd probably...
I would say Grand Rapids is closer than Toronto, closer, right?
At least you don't have to go on the border. I don't know about that.
Not from here. I mean,
Grand Rapids is about 4 or 5, right?
Is it really?
Toronto is a hard 6.
No, you can get there in 5 and some change.
Well, it's about the same.
Well, anyway, Grand Rapids or Toronto. If you really want to go see Don McLean sing songs other than American Pie. But the song has been dethroned by Taylor Swift after 50 years.
I was on the phone. What song of Taylor's did she...
That 10-minute All Too Well...
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Grand Rapids, 4.5 hours. Okay. Yeah. All Too Well. 10 minutes is now the longest song to ever hit number one on the radio.
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Why?
Because they could play it. People will listen. Her fans will listen.
They give Queen all the trouble. I watched Bohemian Rhapsody, and they were like, it has to be 3 minutes for radio to play it. 3 minutes. And Bohemian
Rhapsody. That was a long time ago, though, too.
But what other 10-minute song? I mean, when I was playing, when I was doing WZIP, we had a Justin Timberlake song, and that was, like, Suit and Tie was, like, 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that was long.
Link, things change. And with all due respect, Justin Timberlake ain't no Taylor Swift. So, you know, as popular as he is, Taylor Swift is that rare pop. I mean, she might be alone in it. That pop megawatt, put anything on the radio and people who are fans of hers will listen to it.
She's just too massive. Like, her music is so, it can be used for anything.
She, I guess so.
It's very broad and yet so.
But isn't it crazy to think that she's that popular, and the only song that I can really think of by her is the one where the goat screams?
Trouble? Like, oh no! I knew you were all, trouble. Like, oh god, that is my jam.
Me but and, like, I couldn't even. I couldn't tell you another lyric. I just know that.
Oh god, no,
that
that's
part,
my jam.
Like, in the, that's so funny that, like, she's massively popular.
Yeah, I wrote...
And my kids listened to her music, and so they would listen to it, but, like, none of it sunk in other than that goat song.
And she's
and
been
even,
around...
I didn't even know it was called Trouble. I just thought of it as the goat song.
Called I Knew You Were Trouble. Oh god, me and my
and she's been around for a while now. She turned 32 yesterday, I think.
Yes,
you
did.
Still think of her as being like 21 years old. She's not. She's 22. 32 years old. Yeah. So, yeah.
Is Mug-
and who knows how long? You know, I mean, the world's still her oyster.
I roast Taylor Swift, but. No one can deny her hits.
Why do you roast her?
Because
he takes joy in her sadness.
She gets all the hot D that I want, and she just
well. Why wouldn't you be happy for her?
Looks wise, she could be better. But other than that,
looks wise, she could be better.
Well,
we could all be better looks wise.
Well,
I mean, what do you want? You know, she's infinitely more talented than all of us put together. So. God bless her.
Not if we apply ourselves. If we come together.
That is true.
And
I think if we do kind
drums.
Of a Voltron thing.
Yeah.
I just meant in general. Not even musically. Just
no,
in general.
No, I'm thinking musically. I think together, you know, we're good doing this talk radio thing. But I think if we pool all our experiences and write the perfect song, we can knock Taylor Swift off the charts.
There you go. All we have to do is write an 11-minute hit song.
Yeah.
And then... say goodbye to breaking Don McLean's record because you just got broke yourself.
You better send us some flowers.
Alan, wasn't Don McLean the guy in Nakatomi Tower? No.
It's John McLean.
That was John McLean.
They're brothers.
You know Shake It Off. You know that song. Haters gonna hate, hate, hate.
That's Taylor Swift?
Yeah.
Yes, and there's Blank Space.
I'll tell you the song of hers I really like. Great song. Is Bad Blood. It's a good song. Yep,
yeah,
that's a good song.
God, like,
okay, like
killer
if you
video?
Play them, I might go, okay, but I can't, like, I couldn't have named you another song.
I feel like she's that white girl. She reminds
yes.
me of Zoe off of... No, she,
yes, she is.
She reminds
she
me
is
of,
white.
She reminds me of Zoe from the Proud Family. Like, where I'm from, this is how we do. Like, she's wants to be super woke and super hip, but she got little skinny legs and little skinny arms.
Plus,
and,
all you have to do... is lift enough from songs that predate your audience. This is her song called Lover. It's Bruce Hornsby from 1985.
What?
You just pull like a cool sound and then, you know, you lift enough and then obviously she's very talented, but I mean if you can
just
replicate no, not that song, another one, but I mean you can replicate enough sounds that people kind of recognize and it'll be fine. I'm in the same boat as Bill, someone says. Yeah, but again, her music is not for us.
Right, I know, and I understand. Yeah. But
it is ubiquitous. You cannot get around it.
But I think that's why it's so interesting that you can be so wildly popular and have such a little effect on my life still. I think that's interesting.
That's a good thing.
No, I mean, because it's not for me.
Yeah.
So there's people around me that listen to it and... they know it, and it's important to them. But I hear and I go, play the one with the goat.
That is the best one.
It is the best one.
Yeah. I did have it. Let me find it again here. A lot of people don't know that that was about her failed relationship with livestock. She didn't do any 10-minute version of that because that goat has since passed away. That's so funny. She didn't want to bring any shame or embarrassment to his family.
You see,
Jake Gyllenhaal, though, John Mayer, any one of these other guys?
Jake Gyllenhaal, John Mayer, Harry Styles, Taylor Lautner.
Yeah.
Who else? Just, she has a fantastic.
Jason Alexander.
I don't know who that is.
She did Jason Alexander, Costanza.
Oh. Can't stand ya.
She had one of the Kennedys. Oh, what a fantastic catalog she has. What a fantastic. And no one talks about it, but why would you date someone and not sleep with them? Like, date with someone.
One talks about who Taylor Swift dated.
No, I'm talking
why
about.
Why isn't the mainstream media covering it?
No, I'm talking about sleeping with them.
Oh.
Like, she's probably slept with every boyfriend she has, because why would you date them if you're not going to sleep with them? So I just want to know who's the best. Like, that's what she needs to write a song about. That's what I'll listen to.
Well,
who
but
has the best people, right?
People have been able to listen to her grow up and mature. When you're a young girl and you're voluntarily dating a guy who's 10 years older than you, yeah, it's going to end badly, and you're going to write a song about it. And people are going to go, people who are around your age are going to go, wow, wow, me too. People who are on the older end, the peers of Jake Gyllenhaal, are going to go, welcome to the party, pal.
But it's Jake Gyllenhaal. Like,
so what?
Who wouldn't?
He's a good looking dude.
Yeah, who wouldn't date him? Like, who cares?
He's not for everyone. I mean.
Oh, God. Jake Gyllenhaal.
Now it's probably. He's thirsty.
That was in his prime,
this guy,
like, Brokeback Mountain days.
Man. So thirsty.
I'm not thirsty.
You're not.
But I'm trying to be objective here in the fact that that was probably in his prime where, like, his Brokeback Mountain days, you know, he was ripped and shredded.
He's still ripped and shredded.
I don't know. I haven't seen him lately.
Takes care of himself. He's Jake Gyllenhaal. He's a A-list actor.
One of the Gyllenhaals.
Leonardo DiCaprio never kept himself in that kind of shape, though.
No.
Okay.
That dad bod. He's out there doing it. Alan Cox Show, After Hours Line. People just leave us voicemails there. You can do that. It's 216-986-8903.
Hello, Cox Gang. This is Mike in Akron. And something really dumb and funny. As much as Hot Nuts has really taken off this year and all the permutations we've heard it, I heard Oldie Timey Christmas when I'm listening to the podcast, and I caught it. I know almost every single word to that song. You play it maybe twice or three times a year. I'm concerned at how well I know that song. I don't know why, but I am. Anyway, guys, stay safe. Be healthy. Can't wait to hear you in the new year. And otherwise, ta-ta for now.
Well, looks like it's time to put on our glad rags again. Although this whole thing sounds like a bunch of hokum and flim-flam to me. Say, newsboy, which way to the closest speakeasy? Have an oldie-timey Christmas, like the times of yesteryear. When money was clams and legs were gams, have the barmaid grab a beer. Have an oldie-timey Christmas, getting dizzy with a dame. If she spouts off wise, box her in the eyes, let the gimlet take the blame. Oh, oh, the racism and the women couldn't vote. Don't be a sourpuss, you palooka that gets my goat. Have an oldie-timey Christmas, wax your mustache and put up your dukes. I'll treat you to a little chin music. Let's go on a toot. Don't blow your happy dough on a floozy with busted chops. Slip her a Mickey or two. Oops. And give her the old wet sock. have an oldie-timey Christmas. Grab a stiff two fingers of cheer. Oh, by golly, have an oldie-timey Christmas this year. At the risk of tooting the wrong ringer, I'm going to head off and find myself a reefer. Say, Chinaman, which way to the opium den?
Oh, come on. That's an Asian American right there. Oh, they did
different
so
time
different time.
That.
Different time, boy. Oh, what a different time. Alan, you guys are forgetting about Joe Jonas.
Oh, yeah.
I would never forget about Joe Jonas.
I thought she dated Nick, too.
Her next album should be called I Banged the 2000s. Yeah. See, if they want to blow up the world, she should start dating Pete Davidson.
Now that's what I call ex-boyfriends.
That's right.
Well, I mean,
kids bop 45.
Pete Davidson's got to get through with his Kim Kardashian publicity stunt, and then maybe he can move on to Taylor Swift.
He's with Miley Cyrus now.
Already?
Already.
Is he really?
Yeah. He's on to Miley Cyrus.
It's because Kim passed the baby bar, so she's one step closer to being a lawyer, and she's like, I got to get the hell out of here.
Yeah, no, he's moved on. It was just like that. They did a show together, and now they're hosting the New Year's Eve bash. They're together.
No, he's not with her because she like made some snarky comment about him and Kim. Yep. And Kim got upset.
Because she wanted him.
All right. Wow, look at that. Yeah, this guy, he's just bouncing around. He's loving life.
Also,
I never, ever thought any of this would happen to me. He needs to hook up with Billie Eilish.
I never thought about this. Taylor's never dated a black guy.
How do you know that?
Not publicly.
How do you know that?
What black guy has she dated?
Kevin Hart.
Oh God! Imagine that height difference. Standing next to her.
Kevin Hart's in a trench coat. Standing on her shoulder.
She's better off dating Tiffany Haddish. No, yeah, no. Imagine that. What black guy would be on Taylor Swift's level? Like a Michael B. Jordan.
Kanye. He's single.
Michael B. Jordan's not bad.
Yeah, Michael B. Jordan. That would be a hot couple.
But she clearly likes him older, so she can write a song about him.
Her boyfriend now is not that much older.
Who's the guy now?
He's some actor from another country, and he's white and pasty, just like she likes him.
Huh. All right.
I'm trying to think
Not Idris Elba?
No. Mm. But I'm trying to think of a man of color that she has even dated. And I'm not judging her. Everyone has their preference. And I think her fans might, I hate to say it, but her fans might have an issue with that. We like your songs, but you're singing about a man of color? A colored boy?
No, I don't think so. When she was a country artist, that would probably have been a bigger deal. But she's fully transitioned to pop music. Then that crowd's not going to have a problem with that.
Okay, I wonder.
At least not the people that you have to. Who cares if your fans? Any fans of hers had a problem with it? She'd be like, I don't care. They got billions of dollars. What am I worried about?
Why can't you just keep a man happy?
Because she's married to her work. That's why. Because.
I want a Taylor Swift.
I've got to take a break. You want a what?
Sorry, I wanted Ariana Grande to marry Big Sean, but that was a pipe dream.
Good pun. I've got to take a break. If you want to get a text for anything, 35192. Listen wherever you are throughout North America on the iHeartRadio app.